Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going back to my goth roots from when I was a teen. Basically, I feel like doing something like vampy and dark, and I decided to dress for the occasion. So let's get on to it. So first off, we're gonna start with an eye primer. I'm just using a pretty much colorless base, just because let me put it this way. I sort of want to do a base of gel liner, but I don't want it up to my eyebrow. But I do want some form of primer on my eyebrow area as well. And a colorless primer is just going to be colorless. Whereas if I would use my Maybelline Color Tool, it might mix with the gel liner and just create one big mess. Step one is going to be this. And like I said, gel liner. I'm just going to use a short stump brush. Bit of a round brush. This is actually from the Naked Ultraviolet palette, but like other brands will have it as well with like similar looking tips. And the whole idea is just stiff enough to make sure that I can actually smudge the liner with it. But it's small enough that it gives me a lot of control, but it also keeps it a little bit like, I don't want to do this with an eyeliner brush because the whole thing is I want it to be smoky in the end, so it would only be more difficult for myself to get it smoky if I were to start off with a really, 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 really sharp line in the beginning. But I'm just going to build this up in parts, and the first part is just going to be a very thick wing-ish shape. Now we're going to bring in some more smokiness, for which I'm going to use a fluffier brush. Well, same brush, different side, but you could use a different fluffy brush, of course. And with that, I'm just going to blend this almost dried out gel liner. It's also almost empty. This was not a bright idea. I should have bought a new one. Anyway, I'm going to blend it into my crease. I was thinking at first about doing a full-on smoky eye moment, but I feel like something with a dark crease just looks better on me than a full-on black smoky eye. That's just really not something that actually looks good on me. So yeah, I'm just making this work for my teeth. By the way, in case you've noticed, I've only actually like noticed it recently, but like there's a certain kind of timing to my more dark and gothic like makeup looks. And this is usually the week before I'm on my period. Not really, because, and that is something that I did already notice ages ago, the week before that time of the month, I'm a huge bitch. Like seriously, I'm just. I try to stay nice, but nevertheless, like every tiny thing that normally just would be like whatever pisses me off massively, and there's nothing that pisses me off more than if someone says, oh, PMS or what? I'm sure a lot of my fellow women will recognize that. But hey, at least it makes for like nice dark makeup looks. Next up, time to bring in the shimmer, because even if I'm going for a dark goth look, I still want shimmer, because I love shimmer. Anyway, Jeffree Star Cosmetics Cremated Palette. If you don't have this or whatever, you can just use something else. Similar colors will get similar results. And I'm going to use my big eyeshadow brush, just a flat eyeshadow brush. And just a very nice dark gray with a lot of shimmer in it. Because like I said, I don't want my entire eyelid to be very, very dark, especially not a matte dark shade, because it just makes me look like some kind of ghoul, which, you know, is fun for Halloween, but not really the vibe I'm going for today. Oh, and very obviously, I have not done my face base yet, because with colors like these, well, you know, if you're looking for an adrenaline kick, then I guess it's a good idea. But if you don't want to redo your face base 5 times, I would advise you to just not do your face base until you're done with the eye look. Now to go from this to this, I'm going to use this. An eyeshadow brush, how very surprising. It's just a blending brush, kind of a firm blending brush. I'm going to use black eyeshadow, and I just applied the shimmer right here in this area, but I stopped right next to my outer corner because I'm going to apply the black eyeshadow over top of it anyways. Because as you can tell, gel liner does not blend perfectly. It's not made to. Especially not if it's ancient and dried out, I mean. I've had it for like 5 years, so I probably shouldn't have still been using it in the first place. Full spoiler alert, yes, I'm going to continue using it because I'm that kind of cheapskate, but I will purchase a new one because this is just sort of kind of not useful anymore. Anyway, just gonna blend over the black eyeshadow to make sure, matte black eyeshadow, to make sure it gets a little bit softer. not going too far on top because I'm still going to use a paler shade to blend it up to my eyebrow because I don't want black eyeshadow all the way up to my eyebrow. Because again, I'm not going for the panda look today. And also a little bit below the eye. And at this edge here. Just to make sure it gets smoky instead of smudgy. And then I'm going to go over the edge, like the little border line between the white and the black, with a gray shade. And again the same brush, because really this, you could go fancy and use like 5 different brushes, but in the end I think it actually looks nicer if you use one brush, because it already has remnants of all the colors on it, so it's going to blend a lot nicer. And also afterwards you will only need to wash one brush instead of 5. It's a win-win situation basically. Anyway, I'm gonna use that to blend the upper edge here, so it actually becomes a nice smooth thing. Now we're working with highly contrasting shades here, so be aware that you're probably going to be blending for a while. See you in an hour. And next up, dampen a face halo, makeup eraser wipe. Whatever you use to remove makeup, use it to remove the undoubtedly very obvious fallout. And at this point, I'm not gonna add an eyeliner. I thought I was gonna add an eyeliner, but I'm not gonna add an eyeliner because I think it's dark enough and I like how it looks now and I don't wanna add an eyeliner. Wow, so uncharacteristic. Anyway, I'm going to do my face base now. I'm gonna do it off camera, but if you wanna see more of how I do my face base, I actually did an entire video about it. Not the last video, but the one before that, if I'm correct. You can find it at any rate. It's up on my YouTube channel. And it's recent. And yeah, it's just going to save like 20 minutes of time in this video. So, see you in a second. And the face base is almost done. Any products I've used will be listed below the video, as always, in the video description, in case you want to know. One thing I will tell you separately is my blush color. It's a peachy shade because it fits with anything. And also I want to do a nude lipstick. Because, you know, it is summer after all. In what universe is it a summer look? I don't know, but I'm gonna make it one. Anyway, let's just finish the eyes now. A little bit closer so you can really tell the details now. But I'm just applying a black pencil. You could do this with your gel liner, but mine, as I mentioned before, has completely dried out. So that's not an option, unfortunately. Now I gotta admit, I have absolutely no idea which lashes in particular these are. They're from a set of lashes, but I'll try to look it up, and if I can find it, I'll list it down below as well. But they're pretty comfortable, they're small enough to be comfortable, but they're still pretty spiky, so I like it. And then my bottom lashes can go join the game as well. Then, still 2 steps to go, and one of them is setting spray. Actually, I lied, or I just can't count to 3, because we don't have 2 steps left, we have 3. One of those was the setting spray, the second of which is this highlighter. I'm using one with a silver-ish undertone, because it blends nicely with the eye look. And then the shade is also going to end up on the inner corner. Now I sometimes use eyeshadow for highlights in my inner corner, sometimes an actual highlighter. The reason I'm going for highlighter now is just because I feel like the entire eye look is already pretty shimmery and intense. So I don't feel like shoving heaps of glitter on my inner corners. It's actually going to be useful. Then finally a lipstick, and after that we're officially done. And that leaves us with the final result, including the lipstick. And like I said, it's a very nude shade, but it's, I don't know, like this entire thing is really just the vibe I was going for. Yes, it's not exactly a casual summer look, but then again, who says you can't do a smoky eye in summer? Why not? I like it, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my videos, you can always subscribe to my channel. I do one of them on Tuesday. and sometimes the second one somewhere else in the week if I have time for it. For now, at any rate, thank you very much for watching this. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!